Hello students. So students, we will continue with the same chapter, fundamental unit of life. So we discussed some of the questions in the previous class. So remaining questions we will discuss in today's class. So open page number 65. I gave you one homework question. That is, can you name the two organelles we have studied that carries their own genetic material? Question number one. So the two organelles are nucleus and mitochondria. Okay, so actually chloroplast also has its own genetic material, but they have asked two organelles, so nucleus and mitochondria. Now please open page number 67. Now here in page number 67, I gave question number one and question number two for homework. Question number two actually I discussed with you in the class. Now question number one answer. Make the comparison and write down the ways in which plant cells are different from animal cells. Whenever students difference is asked, you should always write in a tabulated form. So this is the tabulated form. Always write difference whenever it is asked in a tabulated form. So you can write, animal cells are generally small in size. Plant cells are larger than animal cells. Cell wall is absent in animal cell. Plasma membrane of plant cell is surrounded by a rigid cell wall of cellulose. Or you can say cell wall is present in plant cell. Except the protozoans, euglena, no animal cell possesses plastids. So animal cells, generally animal cells doesn't have plastids. Plastids are present in plant cells. Vacuoles in animal cells are many, small and temporary. Plant cells have a permanent and a large central sap vacuole. Then you can write this. Write this. Animal cell have centrosome and centrioles. Plant cell lack centrioles and centrosome. Okay, so this you can write. Now question number four. Question number four, what would happen to the life of a cell if there was no Golgi apparatus or Golgi apparatus? So you can write this answer. There would not be any lysosomes for intracellular digestion and cleansing, not complexing of molecules, no exocytosis and no formation of plasma membrane would have taken place. Okay, because this is the function of Golgi apparatus. What is the function of Golgi apparatus? You should know. And if you know the function of Golgi apparatus, then you could then you can write this answer. Okay, now question number 5, that is homework. Which organelle is known as powerhouse of the cell and why? Question number 6 is also homework. Where do the lipids and proteins constituting the cell membrane get synthesized? Question number 7, how does an amoeba obtain its food? How does amoeba obtain its food? This question, students, you leave, okay? Just leave this question, because this question, for that you have to study the nutrition in amoeba, that is in class 10. Just leave it. What is osmosis? Osmosis, please write the answer. This, all these questions you will do, the questions which I am detecting now or discussing with you now, that you will do in homework copy. And please don't submit the homework, please don't submit the classwork assignments. Okay, is it clear? Because classwork assignments, that I am only giving the answers, so there is no point of submitting the classwork assignments. Only submit homework assignments, and that too during the clarification hour. What is osmosis? Osmosis is the diffusion of water from the region of its higher concentration to the region of lower concentration through semi-permeable membrane, that is plasma membrane. So most of you get confused with diffusion and osmosis. Osmosis is actually the diffusion of solvent particles, the liquid particles, from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration through plasma membrane, but diffusion it can take place in anything. Okay, diffusion, and in that plasma membrane is also not required. Diffusion of solids can also take place, gases can also take place, liquids can also take place. Understood? Now question number 9, carry out the following osmosis experiment. Okay, take 4 peeled potato halves and scoop each other out to make potato cups. 4 peeled potato halves you have to take, that means 2 potatoes you have to take and you have to cut it into halves, so you will get 4 potato halves. Now one of these potato cups should be made from boiled potato. Okay, so one should be made of boiled potato, so in that case you have to take 3 potatoes, boil one potato, cut it into 2 half, take half portion of the boiled potato and cut the remaining 2 potatoes which are unboiled into 2 halves, both the potatoes cut into halves and you will get 4 halves. So 3 halves you take from unboiled potato and 1 you take from boiled potato. Now put each potato cup in a trough containing water. Now keep cup A empty. Cup A empty of what? Potato cup A empty, that is unboiled. Okay, put 1 teaspoon sugar in cup B, put 1 teaspoon salt in cup C, put 1 teaspoon sugar in boiled potato cup D. Understood? So in one potato, in first A1 potato cup, you will not add anything, it will be empty. Okay, it will be empty. Now in potato cup 2, that is B, in B you will add sugar. Okay, and in C you will add salt, and D, which is boiled, which is made up of a boiled potato, okay, you add sugar, but it is boiled. Understood or no? Now keep these for 2 hours and observe the 4 potato cups and answer the following. Explain why water gathers in a hollowed portion of B and C. You will see that water will enter in B and C. Why? Can any one of you answer why it will enter in B and C? Can any one of you, I am just waiting if any one of you can answer. Because here there is sugar and salt, so it is a higher concentration compared to the surrounding. So the water from the trough, it will move, the water will enter from the region of the higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. So in B and C the water concentration is less, so water will enter in the potato B and C, potato cup B and C, because here the concentration of water is less. Understood? Why is potato oil necessary for this experiment? It is kept as a, you can say, reference, it is control, it is kept as control. Okay, it is kept as a control, just to or you can say as a reference experiment. Okay, now you can see here, explain why water does not gather in the hollowed out portion of A and D. Gather in a hollowed out portion of A and D. In A to there was no solute was not present. Okay, here third one, just see. So water does not gather in the hollowed portion of potato cup A because it does not possesses higher osmotic concentration than the cells of other potato. Okay, understood? Because there was no solute was present here, so that is why. And in D, the potato was boiled potato. Okay, so here the cells of the boiled potato it died, and therefore the water did not enter here. Is it clear? I hope it is clear. So that is the answer. Question number 10 is also homework. This is very easy. Please try to do on your own. So in question number 9, if you have any doubt, you can clarify during doubt clarification session. Otherwise, it is easy only. We have done this. This question is based on osmosis only, and osmosis that is the movement of the liquid particles or the solvent particles. Okay, so that is why here it is given. It is the potato is placed in trough containing water. Understood? Okay, it is placed. It is not dipped. Okay. So with this we finish the question answers also of this chapter, and in the next class we will start chapter 6, that is tissues. I hope you have understood the chapter nicely. Just go through the chapter once. Please pay attention. Don't learn the things by heart. Okay, you will not gain anything by learning the things by heart. Please try to understand the things, clarify your concepts. Okay, and attend your online classes regularly. Submit all your assignments on time, not before the time and not after the clarification time. Thank you, students.